We've been discussing about feminism and feminist objectives. How do we ensure that these objectives are effectively reached? And how do we ensure that we reach this purpose actually? Of course, we care about principles and ideas, but we all know very well that feminism is also about redistributing resources and securing practical means to claim and experiment with new non-patriarchal practices. Control over these crucial resources, material and non-material resources, gives us empowerment, which is the right to determine our choices in life and influence the direction of change. How can we implement feminist methods in our organizations if we do not have time to discuss about them? And how do we build feminist alliances if we don't have contacts or money to travel? Feminism needs money, but also experience, skills and expertise, networks. Sometimes organizations, human power or technology makes a difference. Also, non-material resources are precious. Legitimacy, loyalty, public attention, authority, moral commitment and solidarity. In the course of our project, we have realized that many participating organizations do not have enough resources to ensure the engagement and continuity of people and spaces of struggle. Therefore, we started questioning together. Are the organizations mapping how those material resources are distributed and redistributed within the organizations? Who is deciding over these resources and its distribution? And how are decision makers made accountable? Finally, is feminism challenges the traditional ways of raising and expanding resources? Too many questions? Let's try it step by step.
In our collective, we developed a couple of concrete tools to work in this matter.
Well, maybe these tools are not the game changers, but still they can be a nice and strength point to start from. Some of the tools come from the toolkit of feminization of politics and from the executive report we did with our collective. The first of these tools is to seek for funding for specific projects or actions that helps our organizations to incorporate feminization in them or feminization of politics in them. Another one of these tools is to ask ourselves and our organizations how our budget affects women and men and how do they spend money differently. So have this awareness tool that can enable us to track these expenditures we're doing in our organizations and to be aware of how we are spending these money resources. And another one is to decide to carry out a feminization strategy, let us say, through a whole year and define specific activities, trainings and needs and give a specific budget to this strategy of feminization of politics. Some other tools come from some other toolkits, let us say, and one of them is done by Federation of Young European Greens. They did a great fanzine called The Masculinization of Politics. And one of the tools that is proposed in this zine is to create with your organization a network with other particularly feminist or transfeminist organizations. For example, what they did was they were working with Georgian Young Greens and their cooperation with many feminist activist groups in Tbilisi. This enabled them to provide loud feminist voices to be heard inside your organizations, giving some inputs from outside organizations that are feminist can really put some energy and also speed faster the process of our organizations that might not call themselves feminists or to really start discussing and contaminating in the best way with other feminist organizations. Sometimes still, for example, if our organizations are very different from, for example, some identity politics or feminist groups, the priority for our agendas are sometimes different, but it is important that as we are the ones asking them also to collaborate with us, we might have different policies, but it's important to try to find some fields to really work together together in this process of depatriarchalizing our organizations and really working with them. The last one of the tools could be also the inclusion audit. So this tool is about setting a working group that works and has a track on the inclusion within the structures of our organization. This can be important to get an understanding of what is happening in our groups, organizations, to identify problems and to understand the initial steps to tackle this maybe homogeneity of people being in our organization. It should be actually done professionally, so it would be better. And if it's done by an external actor, it could be even better. We could set some peer-to-peer groups with other organizations and set this audit also from outside the organization, but within a peer and a kind of community of practice and network. Also, learning tools can be resources. So we in Asilo, for example, we talked about a lot of how having books and zines and information on the what feminization of politics is, what the patriarchalization of politics is a big resource to share knowledge. Especially as we know sometimes when we are starting to learn, we need a lot of books to read, and this can bring us also to learn together with our organizations on these different books treating different feminist books. Yes, so this would be it. Thank you. And to see more tools, we can actually visit or see or download the reports of the feminization of politics process, or even this scene from the Federation of Young European Greens that is called The Masculinization of Politics. Or also there's another publication called Feminized Politics Now, where you can find more other practical tools to depatriarchalize your organization
or do a feminization of politics strategy within your organization. Thank you.
How can these tools bring to a different way of understanding economy, production and resources? We have tried to reflect on this, starting from the experience of urban commons, which have been all around Europe a way to subtract public real estate to speculation and make it a shared means of production and a resource for solidarity and mutual aid activities. Today, to answer these questions, I am with Roberto Sciarelli and Maria Patrizia Vittoria, who are both components of the Observatory of Commons in Naples. Roberto Sciarelli is a researcher in political sciences and activist in Spugnizzo Liberato, an urban commons in Naples. Maria Patrizia Vittoria is economist at the National Research Center and studies commons in some years ago. So, Maria Patrizia, do you think that commons are resources for marginalized subjectivities, and how, in which sense, what kind of values do they produce?
Diciamo che la struttura stessa o la non struttura del common, in quanto diciamo fondato sulla attività di una comunità informale, è appunto di per sé stesso configurazione che agevola la libera adesione, ovviamente, quindi la possibilità di partecipare in maniera volontaria, spontanea, appunto non formalizzata, che crea sicuramente maggiore apertura, maggiore partecipazione, ma quello che è ancora più importante, maggiore efficacia all'azione stessa del gruppo.
And you, Roberto, what do you think?
Yes, in my opinion, for sure, commons understood the shared resources cared for and self-governed by communities of commoners are most definitely a resource for marginalized groups, marginalized subjectivities, in the sense that everywhere in the world the commons are claimed, defended by indigenous populations, by working women and in general by subaltern groups of society which decide to share means of production, to share different social relationships, experience in and of course commons are always claimed by peoples involved in environmental conflicts. So they also have a deep meaning for ecological issues. In my experience as an activist and researcher of the Commons of Naples, here in this city, the commons are also understood as the institution of the subaltern. This was actually an answer given to me by a comrade of mine when I asked him about what is a commons, and yes, the institution of the subaltern in the sense of being a political experience that is part of a long history of self-organization of the subaltern groups of the society, which here in southern Italy, in Naples in particular, are often ignored, marginalized by both the state and the capitalist market.
Thank you both for your answers. How do you think that commons also entail maybe different ways of organizing the production of these values that you that this value that you have spoken about?
Certo, la variabile organizzativa è un aspetto assai interessante per l'analisi dell'efficacia dell'azione del common, perché praticamente la chiave di volta è sicuramente l'aspetto partecipativo, l'azione appresa dal basso. E poi realizzata dall'insieme è sicuramente più efficace. Quindi ciò che genera valore dal punto di vista della variabile organizzativa è appunto la partecipazione, grande segreto della vera partecipazione.
Thank you, Maria Patrizia. And Roberto, do you think that this also entails a reorganization of care labor?
Yes, the Commons of Naples, as part of the general commoning movement of southern Italy, do organize in different ways care labor, care work, for different reasons. First of all, they organize mutualistic activities and communitarian support for the people of their district in the form of cooperation of workers and communitarian welfare. For example, here in Naples it is common, yes, it is quite common to have in the commons activities like shared kitchen, solidary wardrobes, or spaces of mutual help for families, especially for marginalized groups like migrants, for example. This is all part of a general understanding of what a commons, of the fact that commons should work to build caring communities in the urban landscape in which they arose, not only urban, of course, because there are also commons which do the same things in the countryside. But this is not the only way in which care work is differently understood and organized in the commons, since the commons of Naples are, first of all, big shared buildings, infrastructures, spaces, which have to be cared for, since the space the shared resource is so central for the politics of the commoners. Also, the care for these spaces and resources is very politically central, which means that even if there are still patriarchal relationships of power, distribution of merits, and work in the commons, there is also a different distribution of care work, material care work, and also relational care work. In these political experiences, exactly because care has been recognized as especially central for our politics.
Thank you both. And one last thing, very useful, I think, for our social movements and also, I think, feminist movement in general. How do you think we can make all this value visible, of course, without commodifying it?
Il processo per portare alla luce, per rendere visibile il commons value è un processo complesso, che implica l'adozione di chiavi di lettura teoriche e pratiche ed empiriche. La teoria sicuramente fornisce tutte le diverse ipotesi di valore, tutti i diversi ambiti da andare ad esplorare. A questi quindi si deve ovviamente associare l'osservazione del caso specifico e quindi andare a scegliere l'eventuale metodologia poi di misurazione dello specifico fenomeno, dello specifico aspetto. Le tecniche di misurazione sono numerosissime. Ovviamente si varia da quelle basate sull'analisi dei costi, poi a quelle basate sulla individuazione dei volumi prezzo-quantità ispirati ai listini dei prezzi ombra. Non so se questo sia chiaro, ma comunque anche la stessa valutazione dello SROI, del CROI, come di recente è stato detto, è un'altra metodologia da mettere in campo. Insomma, quindi è bene avere la linea guida dell'analisi teorica e quindi di conseguenza adattare la tecnica di valutazione al caso empirico, al caso specifico.
On this issue, I think that what Maria Patrizia said is of extreme importance. I do not have a lot to say on this matter, but I want to highlight an issue that to visibilize the value created by the commons, it is indeed a matter of economic counting, statistics, how do we translate the qualitative value that we produce in quantitative numbers. This is for sure an issue that should be investigated, but it is also a matter of politics, so a political recognition. Here in Naples, one of the people running for office of the mayor of the municipality of Naples started his campaign attacking social centers, occupied spaces, and also commons. This means that even if we have 10 years of experience of social work and political and social cooperation in different districts of the city, there is still a big sector of politics of the society which undervalue, diminish, lessen the work done by the commons and do not recognize it. So, I think that in general, the work that we do is really visible, and the value we produce is visible in the sectors of society that we meet, with which we cooperate. So, more than making visible, I think that this is also, or not more, but before making something visible, there is also the issue of stopping to invisibilize what we do and to degrade what we do. And So
so,
yes,
yes,
the
the
issue
issue
of
of
counting or measuring what we do is first of all also the issue of how do we politically recognize what the commons do.
Okay, so thank you very much, Roberto and Maria Patrizia, and hope there will be other ex occasions to exchange. Thank you.
Okay, bye bye. Ciao.